3-dimensional vectors, level 3. In this final video on 3-dimensional vectors, we will go over 4 examples. The last example will be a static equilibrium problem in 3 dimensions. Alright, let's go ahead and take a look at the first example. Sketch vector v and write its component form. Vector v lies in the yz plane, has a magnitude of 2, and makes an angle of 30 degrees with a positive y-axis. Alright, since this vector lies on a plane, it will have one component equal to 0. In this case, the x component will be equal to 0. Now, to determine the value of the other components, we can go ahead and use right triangle trigonometry to find the y and z components of the vector. According to the problem, vector v makes an angle of 30 degrees with a positive y-axis. This means that it can form two separate angles, positive 30 degrees and negative 30 degrees. So we have two solutions that satisfies the conditions of the problem. Now that we have identified our vectors, it is just a matter of using the 30-60-90 special right triangle to determine the values of the y and z components. Doing that, we obtain the following expression. Now, for the y component, cosine of positive 30 degrees and cosine of negative 30 degrees yield the same value, and when multiplied by the magnitude, it would reduce to the square root of 3. But, for the z component, sine of 30 degrees and sine of negative 30 degrees yield different answers that differ only by negative sign. So taking this into account and simplifying the expression, we obtain positive and negative 1 for the z component. So the components of the vectors that satisfy the conditions of the problem are equal to 0, square root of 3, and positive negative 1. Alright, let's try another similar problem. Vector v lies in the xz plane, has a magnitude of 5, and makes an angle of 45 degrees with a positive z-axis. Similar to the previous example, let's go ahead and make a sketch of the problem. Notice that we can also form two separate vectors that make an angle of 45 degrees with a z-axis. So this problem will also have two solutions. Since the vectors lie in the xz plane, the vectors will have a y component equal to 0. At this point, it is just a matter of using right triangle trigonometry and find the components of each vector. If we change our point of view and focus on the xz plane, we would see the following. Now, if we use the standard conventions for measuring angles, the first vector would make an angle of 45 degrees relative to the positive x-axis, and the second vector would make an angle of 135 degrees relative to the x-axis. Using these values for the angle, we can compute the values of each component by using the ratios of a 45-45-90 special triangle and then multiply by the magnitude of the vector. Doing that, we obtain the following for the first vector: 5 times the square root of 2 over 2, 0, and 5 times the square root of 2 over 2. For the second vector, the values of each component will be the same, but the x, or i-hat component, will be negative, since cosine of 135 degrees yields a negative value. Alright, let's go over the next example. Use vectors to find the point that lies 2/3 of the way from point P to point Q. Alright, let's go ahead and plot these points to get a graph that we can work with. We are asked to determine the coordinate point that is 2/3 of the way from point P to point Q. We can determine this by first finding the component form of the vector represented by the points P and Q. So we go ahead and subtract the initial point from the terminal point. Then we simplify the expression, obtaining negative 3, negative 6, and 3 for the components. Next, let's go ahead and scale this vector by a factor of 2/3. Doing that, we obtain the following components. Now, this component essentially tells us the difference between point P and the point that is 2/3 away from point P. So all we need to do is to take point P and add the components of the scaled vector. Doing that, we obtain the final coordinate equal to 2, negative 1, and 2. Alright, let's end the video with a final example. Find the tension in each of the supporting cables in the figure below if the weight of the crate is 500 newtons. Alright, here we have a static equilibrium problem in three-dimensional space. The concepts of static equilibrium are the same. The sum of all the forces acting on a body has to equal zero. For this particular problem, we have a crate that is hanging from three ropes attached at various parts relative to a three-dimensional coordinate system. We are given the coordinates of points A, B, C, and D. Alright, the first step is to find an expression for each of the forces that are acting on point A. This is going to include three tension forces, one for each rope, and the weight of the box. Let's first find an expression for each of the three tension forces. Let's label three separate vectors by using the points that are provided to us. These forces will represent the tension force along point A and point B, along point A and point C, and the tension force along point A and point D. Next, we need to write the component form for each vector. The only problem is that we currently have no idea what the magnitude of each tension force is, but we are able to at least find the components for the direction of each of the tension force by using the coordinate points provided to us. The component form of the force from point A to point B can be found by taking point A and subtracting it from point B. The component form of the force from point A to point C can be found in a similar fashion. And the force from point A to point D will also be found in the same way. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the following for the direction of each tension force. Now, we currently have no idea what the magnitude of the force for each tension is equal to, but we know that if we were to take the direction of each tension force and multiply it by some scalar C sub 1, C sub 2, and C sub 3, for each of the forces, we should be able to obtain the component form for each tension force. We will use these constants along with the direction of the ropes to temporarily represent the tension forces. We will also express the weight of the crate as a force with only one component, in this case, negative 500 newtons along the negative Z axis. Now we can go ahead and find the sum of all the forces and set it equal to zero, as follows. Next, we need to extract three separate equations, one for each component. For the X component, we obtain the following equation. For the Y component, we obtain the following. And for the Z component, we get the following expression. Now we are face to face with a system of equations. So we have three unknowns and three equations. We should be able to find the solution for each of the constants. Using the first equation, we go ahead and solve for C sub 2. And using the second equation, we go ahead and solve for C sub 1. This allows us to substitute these constants into the third equation, reducing it into an equation with a single variable. From here, it is just a matter of collecting like terms and solving for C sub 3. Simplifying the expression, we obtain the following value for C sub 3. Now we go ahead and solve for C sub 1 and C sub 2. Doing that, we obtain the following values. The last step is to go back to our expressions, representing the tension force for each rope, and substitute these scalars, and then multiply it by each rope's direction vector. This generates the component form for each tension force. And finally, all we need to do is to find the magnitude of each tension force by using the Pythagorean theorem in three dimensions. Approximating the magnitudes, we obtain the following values for each of the forces. Alright, and this ends the video series on three-dimensional vectors. In our next series of videos, we will go over a new vector operation called the dot product.